Welcome to Leader IAS and Yashas Institute. Myself Professor Suhas Sargar from Navi Mumbai. Dear listeners, these are the self-explanatory audio video book for the self-study of a student. Today in this video, we all going to learn and understand State Board of Maharashtra, Standard 10th, Subject Science and Technology Part 2, Chapter Number 5, Towards Green Energy. So let's begin. Towards a green energy, use of the various energy sources, generation of electrical energy, and the process of generation of electricity and environment. So what is energy? What are the different types of energy? What are the different forms of energy? Let us discuss. Make a list of the work that we do in our day-to-day life using energy. Which forms of energy do we use to do this work? Discuss with your friend. Energy and use of energy. In modern civilization, energy has become a primary need along with the food, cloth, and shelter. We need energy in a different forms for diverse types of work. The energy that we need may be in the form of mechanical energy, chemical energy, sound energy, light energy, or heat energy. How do we get these different forms of energy? Make a table based on forms of energy and corresponding devices. We know that energy can be converted from one form to another. Different sources of energy are used to different forms of energy necessary for us. In previous standard, we have learned about energy, sources of energy, and various concepts related to them. Here, we learn about various sources that are now used for the generation of electrical energy. The methods that are used for these, the scientific principles that are used there, the advantages and disadvantages of this method, and also what is meant by green energy. Where do we use electrical energy in our day-to-day life? How electrical energy is produced? Generation of electrical energy. Most of the electrical power plants are based on different electromagnetic induction invented by the Michael Faraday. According to this principle, whenever the magnetic field around a conductor changes, a potential difference is generated across the conductor. The field around a conductor can be changed into two ways. If a conductor is stationary and magnet is rotating, the field around the conductor changes, or if a magnet is stationary but the conductor is moving, then also the field around the conductor will change. Thus, in both the cases, a potential difference is created across the conductor. The electrical power generating machine based on this principle is called electrical generator. Such a large generator are used in commercial power generation plants. Turbine is used to rotate the magnet in the generator. A turbine has blade. When a flow of liquid or gas is directed on a blade of turbine, it rotates. Because of the kinetic energy of the flow, the turbine is connected to the electrical generator. Thus, the magnet in electrical generators start rotating and electrical energy is produced. So this method of electrical energy generation can be represented as below. Thus, to generate electricity based on the principle of electromagnetic induction, we need a generator to rotate the generator. We need a turbine and to drive the turbine. We need an energy source based on which the types of energy sources used to rotate the turbine. There are the different types of power generating stations. The design of the turbine used in different types of power station is also different. Proper energy sources to run turbine, generator, and electrical energy. Flow chart of showing generation of electrical energy. See it in the picture. Thermal energy based on electrical power station. In this, the turbine is rotated using steam. Water is heated in the boiler. Using the thermal energy release due to burning of coil, steam of very high temperature and pressure is generated. The energy in the steam drives the turbine. Thus, the generator connected to the turbine rotates and electrical energy is produced. The steam is converted back into water and the water is recirculated to the boiler. This is shows flow chart of figure V5.5. See the flow chart of showing generation of electrical energy using thermal energy. Some thermal energy is used here to generate the electrical energy. Such power plants are called the thermal power plant. In thermal power plant, the chemical energy in the coil is converted into electrical energy through the several steps which are shown in figure 5.6. Energy transformation in thermal power plant. Chemical energy in a coil, thermal energy, kinetic energy in steam, kinetic energy in turbine, and electrical energy. Let's think few questions. Why the energy in the coil is called as chemical energy? Why the steam is used to rotate the turbine, etc. See the pictures of schematic of the thermal power plant. If you see a thermal power station, you will observe the two types of the towers there. What are they? If you observe the schematic of the thermal power station in figure 5.7, you will get answer to these questions. Compare the schematic of the thermal power station with the block diagram above and you will understand how the boiler, turbine, generator and condenser are arranged in the power station. After combustion of fuel, here coil in the boiler, the emitted gene are released to the atmosphere through very high power. Once the turbine is rotated using the steam at a high temperature and a high pressure, the steam temperature and the pressure decreases. The steam is converted back to water by taking out heat from it, that is by cooling it. This is done in the condenser using water in the cooling tower. The water in cooling tower is circulated through the condenser. Heat energy in the steam is given to the water and the steam condenses back to water. The heat absorbed by the water is then released to the atmosphere through vapor and heated air through cooling water. Although the thermal power generation is a major way of electricity generation today, it suffers from certain problems. In box, use of ICT. Prepare a presentation about thermal power station plant using computerized presentation, animation, video pictures, etc. Send it to the others and upload on YouTube. Problems. Air pollution is due to burning of coal. Burning of coal results in emission of gases like carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide, which are the harmful to the health. Along with the emission of gases due to burning of coal, soot particles are also released into the environment. This may cause a serious health problem related to the respiratory system. The reserves of the fuel used in this method, that is the coal, are limited. Therefore, in future, there will be the limitation on the availability of the coal. Power plant based on nuclear energy. On the power plant based on nuclear energy also, steam turbine is used to rotate the generator. However, here the energy released by fission of nuclei of atom like uranium or platinum is used to generate the steam of high temperature and high pressure. The energy in the steam rotates the turbine, which in turn drives the generator, producing electricity. The flow chart of the nuclear power plant is shown in figure 5.8. Nuclear reactor for nuclear fission. System for steam generation from water. Steam turbine, generator, electrical energy. System for conversion of the steam back into water. Fuel, uranium or plutonium. See the pictures of nuclear power plant. Thus, here the nuclear energy is converted into thermal energy. Thermal energy is converted into the kinetic energy of steam. Kinetic energy of the steam is converted into the kinetic energy of turbine. And finally, the kinetic energy of the turbine is converted into electrical energy. The step-by-step transformation of energy is shown in figure 5.5. Energy transformation in nuclear power plant. How does the nuclear fission take place? Question. Whether the neutron is bombarded on atom of uranium-235, it absorbs the neutron and converts into the isotope uranium-236. Uranium 236, being extremely unstable, converts into atoms of barium and krypton through a process of fusion, releasing 3 neutrons and 200 mV energy. The 3 neutrons generated in the process cause the fusion of the 3 other uranium 235 atoms, releasing more energy. The neutron release in the reaction less more energy through fission of more uranium nuclei. The process of fission of uranium 235 atom continues and is called the chain reaction. In nuclear power plants, the control chain reaction results in the release of thermal energy, which is used for electrical energy generation. Nuclear fission, see the diagram of chain reaction. Also see the diagram of schematic of the nuclear power plant. A nuclear power plant does not use a fossil fuel like coal. Therefore, the problems like air pollution do not arise. Also, if the sufficient nuclear fuel is available, then can be a good source of electrical energy. However, there are the few problems associated with the nuclear power stations or the generation problem. The product after fission of nuclear fuel are also radioactive and emit the harmful radiations. The product are called the nuclear waste. How to dispose the nuclear waste safely is a big challenge before the scientists. An accident in nuclear power plant can be very fatal. This is because the accident may result in the release of very harmful radiation. Compare. Observe the schematic of the thermal power plant and the nuclear power plant. Discuss what are the similarities and the differences between the two. Power generation plant based on energy of natural gas. In this plant, the turbine is run by gas at a very high temperature and the pressure generated in a combination of combustion of natural gas. A flow chart showing various stages in the power generation plant based on natural gas energy is shown in figure 5.12. See the pictures of arrangement in the power plant based on energy of natural gas. There are the three main sections in this type of plant. Pressurized air is introduced into the combustion of chamber using a compressor. In the combustion of chamber, the natural gas burns in presence of air. The gas at a very high temperature and pressure generated in this chamber runs the turbine. The turbine then drives the generator to produce electricity step by step. Transformation of energy in this plant is shown in figure 5.13. Transformation of the energy in a power plant using energy of natural gas. The efficiency of this type of the power generation plant is high than that of the power generation plant based on coal. Moreover, since the natural gas does not contain sulfur, burning of natural gas results in less pollution. The schematic of the power plant based on natural gas is as given in figure 5.14. Schematic power plant based on natural gas. Let's think, which electricity generation process is an eco-friendly and which not? Always remember, though use of energy is unavoidable in our day-to-day life, it is necessary to use it carefully and only in the required amount. Electrical energy generation and environment. Electricity generation is based on fossil fuel like coal, natural gas and nuclear fuels like uranium and plutonium are not eco-friendly, environment-friendly. It means that if electrical energy is generated using these fuels, it can lead to environment degradation. We have seen the burning of fossil fuels like coal, natural gas leads to emission of certain gases and soot particles. This results in air pollution. Incomplete combustion of fuel leads to formation of carbon monoxide. It adversely affects the health. Increase in percentage of carbon dioxide in the air due to burning of fuels affect the environment severely. The phenomenon of global warming is an example of this. Nitrogen dioxide generated due to burning of fuel like coal, diesel, petrol, etc. lead to the problems like acid rain. Soot particles generated due to incomplete burning of fossil fuel cause air pollution. It can lead to problems related to the respiratory system like asthma. It looks millions of years for formation of fossil fuels like coal, crude oil and natural gases, LPG and CNG. Also, the reserves of these fuels are limited. They are going to deplete in the future. It is said that with the current speed of their use, the coal reserves in the world would last for another about 200 years or so, and the natural gas reserve are for about 200 to 300 years. We have also discussed about the problems in use of nuclear energy, like the disposal of the nuclear waste and possibility of the disaster due to accident in nuclear power plant. Considering all these points, it can be said that the energy generation from fossil fuels and the nuclear fuel are not environment friendly. Hydroelectric energy. Kinetic energy in a flowing water or the potential energy in a water reservoir is a conventional source of energy. In hydroelectric power plant, the potential energy in water stored in a dam is converted into kinetic energy of water. Fast flowing is brought from the dam to the turbine at the bottom of the dam. The kinetic energy of the flowing water drives the turbine. The turbine in turn drives the generator to generate the electricity. The block diagram showing different components of hydroelectric power plant is shown in figure 5.15. The different stages in hydroelectric power plants. Electricity generation using wind energy. Energy transformation in hydroelectric power plant. The schematic of the hydroelectric power plant is shown in figure 5.17. Water from about middle of the total height of the dam is taken into turbine, as shown in point B in diagram. Schematic of hydroelectric power. Use your brain. With a reference to the point B, potential energy of is how much water reservoir in the dam will be converted into the kinetic energy? In box, since no fuel is burned in hydroelectric plant, no air pollution due to combustion of fuel result. However, considering the issue like forced migration of large community, submerging of forest and fertile land, adverse effect on living creatures in the river, it has always been a point of debate whether the hydroelectricity is eco-friendly or not. What is your opinion about it? Inbox. Advantages of hydroelectric power generation. First, since no fuel is burned in hydroelectric power generation, there is no pollution resulting from combustion of fuels. If there is a sufficient water storage in the dam, it is possible to generate the electricity as and when necessary. Although the water reservoir is used for power generation, it can be replenished during the rainy season, leading to uninterrupted power generation. Problems associated with hydroelectric power plants. The backwater due to storage of water in a dam may submerge villages or towns in that area. This leads to the problems of rehabilitation of the displaced population. Moreover, this can also submerge the forest as well as the fossil fuels, fossil land. The obstruction of the flow of river water may have adverse effect on living world in the river. Box close. Do you know? Please read or see in the diagram the Koyna Dam picture. Kinetic energy in the wind has been used since long for lifting of water, for driving flour mill, etc. The wind energy can also be used for electricity generation. The machine which converts the kinetic energy of wind to electrical energy is called the wind turbine. As the wind strikes the blades of the blade rotates. The axle of turbine is connected to electric energy generator through a gearbox. The function of gearbox is to increase the rotation per unit time. Thus, the rotating blades drives the turbine and turbine in turn drives the generator to generate electricity. The various stages in the wind energy generation steam can be shown in figure 5.19 and the schematic of the wind will show in figure 5.20. See both these pictures. 5.21, the transformation of the energy is an electric generator using wind energy. The wind turbines with the capacity right from less than 1 kilowatt to about 7 megawatt, that is 7 kilowatt, are commercially available. Depending on the wind velocity available at the site of installation, the wind turbine with a specific capacity is selected. The wind velocity at a specific location depends on many geographical factors. The wind velocity is usually high on seashore, and that environment is appropriate for installation of the wind turbine. The wind energy is a clean energy source. However, the wind velocity necessary for the wind energy generation is not available everywhere. In that sense, use of the wind energy is limited. Get information. Get information about major wind power stations in India and their capacity. Make a table of their location, state, and their power generation capacity in megawatt. The wind turbines of the different capacity. Electrical energy using solar energy. Using energy is in the sunlight. Electric energy can be generated in two ways. First, in all the above method of electric generation we have studied, the electrical generator is driven by using some sources of energy, and electricity is generated by making use of principle of electromagnetic induction. However, electric energy can be generated directly from solar radiation without using generator and without using the principle of electric magnetic induction. This happens in solar photovoltaic cell. The solar photovoltaic cell convert the solar energy directly into electrical energy. In the second method, the energy in a solar radiation is converted into thermal energy first. Then a turbine generator system is driven using the thermal energy to generate electricity. Solar photovoltaic cell. Solar photovoltaic cell converts the solar radiation energy directly from electrical energy. This is called solar photovoltaic effect. The electrical energy is generated through the energy transformation process in DC is in nature. These solar cells are made of a special type of the material called semiconductor. Example, silicon. A silicon solar cell of the dimension 1 cm square generates a current of about 30 milliampere and potential difference of about 0.5 volt. Thus, a silicon solar cell of the dimension 100 cm square will generate about the 3 ampere current and the 0.5 volt. Remember, the potential difference available from a solar cell is independent of the area. If the two solar cells are connected in a series as shown in a figure 5.23, see the pictures of solar cells in series. The potential difference obtained from the combination of is addition of the potential difference of the individual solar cell. However, the current generated from these combination is equal to the current form of individual cell. It means that when the solar cell are connected in a series, the currents from the individual cells are not added. Similarly, shown in figure 5.424, if the two solar cells are connected to the parallel, the current generated from these combination is a summation of the current from an individual solar cell. However, the potential difference obtained from this combination is the same as the potential difference obtained from individual cell. Thus, if the two solar cells are connected in the parallel, the potential difference from the two cells are not added. In this way, by connecting many solar cells in a series and in a parallel solar panel, generating required current and the potential difference are made. If the 36 solar cell, each of the size 100 cm square, are connected in a series in a solar panel, it will give potential difference of 18 volt and the current 3 ampere. Many such panels are connected together to generate electricity on a large scale. A good solar cell can have an efficiency of around 15%. It means that if the solar panel receives the power of 100 watt from the solar rotation, the electrical power output from the panel will be 15 watt. The many solar panels are connected in a series and in a parallel. to generate the required current and the potential difference. As shown in the figure 5.26, the solar cell is the basic unit of solar electric plant. Many solar cells come together to form a solar panel. Many solar panels connected in the series form a solar string, and many solar string connected in a parallel form a solar arrays, as which can be obtained as much electric power is needed. They are used in applications which need marginal power, example calculators. Thus, that run on a solar energy to the power station of MW capacity. The power available from the solar cell in a DC. So, in application which need the DC power, example electrical light bulbs on light emitting diode, the energy can be directly used. However, since the energy from solar cell is available only in presence of sunlight, the energy has to be stored in batteries for use at later times. See the pictures of 5.27, conversion of energy generated by cell to AC from by using inverter. However, most of the equipment in domestic as well as industrial use run on AC power. In such case, the DC solar power plant must be converted to AC power using an electrical device or electronic device called as an inverter. Schematic of the solar power photovoltaic station, see it in the pictures. We have seen that many solar panels can be connected together to generate whatever energy we need, as shown in figure 5.28. The DC power generated from these panels is used first converted into AC power. A transformer transforms the voltage and the current levels of generated power, and then it is fed into electricity distribution network. Figure 5.28, see it in the pictures. This is a schematic diagram of the solar photovoltaic power station. In this way, electricity is generated without any fuel combustion and so without any air pollution. However, since the energy is generated using solar radiation, solar cells can generate the electricity during daytime only. Solar thermal power plant. We have seen that the thermal energy generated from coal and a nuclear fuel can be used to generate electricity. The thermal energy can be used generated from solar radiation and can be used for electricity production. Different stages in such solar thermal power plant are shown in figure 5.29. Different stages in solar thermal power plant. See it in the pictures. As shown in the figure, many reflectors reflect and concentrate the solar radiation on absorber. The solar energy is converted into heat energy. Using this heat energy, steam is generated to drive the turbine and generator. Now, schematic of the solar thermal power plant. See it in the pictures. So, friends, thanks for listening. We are from Leader IS and Yashas Institute, Navi Mumbai. Myself, Professor Suhas Sargar. These are the self-explanatory audio video book for the self-study of a student. Thanks for listening.